Oh, don't do that.
Ready? One more. Let me take one more. Hold on a second. We'll take one long way here. This looks good here, guys. Look at me. Billy, stand up. That was pretty funny.
Oh, look here. Oh, very lovely. Hello. Oh,
hey, you feet all right?
No,
they look cold.
They look fine.
Oh, they're beautiful. Great, they look wonderful. Hey, Tony.
Boy, you look great, Gus.
How are you?
Nice.
How are
you doing? My nephew, Bill, this is my nephew, Chris.
Okay, I heard him.
Okay. It was his son.
Boy, you're slick there, big guy.
Are you going to walk down with Paige if she won't come down by herself? Is that the plan?
No, there's a girl that's
just on. Leave it for whoever has the camera. I don't know.
The priest is actually doing it.
There's a child.
I know. Oh, she could ask her. What time did you get here?
Get a big smile on your face.
And you know what? Yeah.
Good. Hello. Good.
How much money would you say? Hello.
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 Directions to the reception as well as the program.
Likewise. How are you doing?
Yes, I remember from last time.
Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. O Lord, our God, involved with the servant of Abraham the patriarch when he was sent to Mesopotamia to find a wife for his master Isaac, revealing to him to arrange by the drawing of water betrothal of Rebekah. Bless also now the betrothal of these, your servants, George and Captain, and confirm the word with which they have been given. Strengthen them in the sacred union, which is from you. For you have created from the beginning male and female, and by you is the woman joined to man as a helpmate for the propagation of the race of man. You have sent, the Lord our God, the truth to your people and your promise to your servants, our fathers, your elect from generation to generation. Look now upon these, your servants, George and Catherine Ann, and confirm your pledge in faith and concord and truth and love. For you, O Lord, declared that a pledge be given and confirmed in all things. With the ring Joseph, who was given authority in Egypt. With the ring Daniel was glorified in the land of Babylon. With the ring the truth was revealed to Tamar. With the ring our Heavenly Father was merciful to the prodigal son, for he said, put a ring on his right hand, kill it, and bring the fatted calf and kill it, and let us eat and make merry. Your right hand, the Lord, helped Moses to cross the Red Sea, and by your unfailing command, the heavens were made firm and the earth was established. Now the right hand of your servants shall be blessed by your mighty word and with your powerful arm. Bless also, O Lord, the displacement of the rings with the heavenly blessing. And may the angel of the Lord go before them all the days of their lives. For you bless and sanctify all things, and to you we offer glory to the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and always, and to the ages of ages. Amen. For the Holy Church and for those who enter with faith, reverence, and fear of God, let us pray to the Lord. For our Church of Spirit, on the Reverend Priests and Deacons in Christ, for all the clergy and people, let us pray to the Lord. For the servants of God, George and Catherine Ann, who are now united in the fellowship of marriage, and for their salvation, let us pray to the Lord. That this marriage may be blessed as the marriage at Cana of Galilee, let us pray to the Lord. That they may be given the grace to be chaste and to have children as it may be best for them, let us pray to the Lord. That they may rejoice in the sight of sons and daughters, let us pray to the Lord. That they may be granted the enjoyment of good children and a life above reproach, let us pray to the Lord. That all of us may be granted all petitions for salvation, let us pray to the Lord. Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and protect us, O God, by thy grace, remembering our most holy, pure, blessed, and glorious Lady Theotokos, and ever Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commit ourselves and one another and our whole life to Christ our God. For all glory, honor, and worship belongs to you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and always, and to the ages of ages. Let us pray to the Lord. O God, most holy and author of all creation, when your loving kindness fashioned woman from the side of Adam and said, increase and multiply and have dominion over the earth, and who declare the two into one, and for this reason a man shall leave his father and his mother and shall be joined to his wife, and the two shall be one flesh. And let no man separate those whom God has united. You blessed your servant Abraham and opened the womb of Sarah, and so made him father of many nations. You gave Isaac to Rebekah and blessed her with children. You joined Jacob to Rachel, and through him you established the 12 patriarchates. You accepted Zacharias and Elizabeth, ordaining the child to be the forerunner, and from the root of Jesse you caused to blossom the virgin, and from her you took flesh, and was born for the salvation of the race of man. Do you now, Holy Master, accept the prayer of us, your supplicants? And as you did, then being invisibly present here, bless this marriage, and grant to these your servants, George and Catherine Ann, a peaceful life, length of days, wisdom, love for one another with peace that binds them together. Long live posterity, the joy of children, the crown of unfading glory. Grant them to see their children's children. Preserve the sanctity of their home and give to them of the dew of heaven and of the abundance of the earth. Keep their homes well supplied with grain, wine, oil, and every other good thing, so that they may also give to those in need. And to all present here, grant all petitions for salvation. For you are the God of mercy, love, and compassion, and to you we offer glory with your Father, who is from everlasting, and your life-giving Spirit, now and forever, to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Let us pray to the Lord. Blessed are you, O Lord our God, the celebrant of mystical and hallowed marriage, and the ordainer of the physical marriage, the guardian of eternal life, and the kind provider of the needs of this life. Do now the same Lord who in the beginning created man and set him as a master of creation and said, it is not good that man should be alone. I will make him a helpmate. And taking one of his ribs, you created woman. And when Adam saw her, he said, this is now bone from my bones and flesh from my flesh. She shall be called woman because she was taken from man. This is why a man leaves his father and mother and is joined to his wife, and the two become one. Therefore, let no man separate those whom God has united. Do now the same, Lord our God, send your heavenly grace upon these, your servants, George and Catherine, and grant that this, your handmaid, Catherine, may respect her husband in everything, and that this, your servant, George, may cherish and love his wife, that they may live according to your will. Oh, bless them, O Lord our God, as you blessed Abraham and Sarah. Bless them, O Lord our God, as you blessed Isaac and Rebekah. Bless them, O Lord our God, as you blessed Jacob and all the patriarchs. Bless them, O Lord our God, as you blessed Joseph and Asenath. Bless them, O Lord our God, as you blessed Moses and Zipporah. Bless them, O Lord our God, as you blessed Joachim and Anna. Bless them, O Lord our God, as you blessed Zacharias and Elizabeth. Protect them, O Lord our God, as you protected Noah in the ark. Protect them, O Lord our God, as you protected Jonah inside the whale. Protect them, O Lord our God, as you protected the three holy children from the fire, sending down upon them dew from heaven. And may that joy come upon them which St. Helen felt when she found the precious cross. Remember them, O Lord our God, as you remembered Enoch, Shem, and Elias. Remember them, O Lord our God, as you remember the 40 holy martyrs when you sent down upon them crowns from heaven. Remember, O Lord our God, the parents who raised them, for the blessings of the parents strengthen the foundation of the home. Remember, O Lord our God, your servants, the attendants, and all those who gather at this joyous ceremony. Remember, O Lord our God, your servant, George, and your handmaid, Catherine Ann, and bless them, grant to them a fruitful union, good children and concord of body and soul. Exalt them like the cedars of Lebanon, like a fruitful vine. Bless them with all material gifts, so that in having sufficiency for themselves, they may also abound in good works which are pleasing to you. And may they see their children's children gathering like young olive trees around their table. And finding favor in your sight, may they shine like the stars in heaven, in you our Lord. For to you are due glory, honor, and worship, with your Father who is from everlasting, and your life-giving Spirit, now and always to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
O holy God, who formed man from the dust and fashioned woman and joined her to him as a helpmate, For so pleased your majesty that man should not be alone upon the earth. Extend now, O Lord, your hand from heaven. And join your servant George and your handmaid Catherine Ann, for by you is the husband united to the wife. Unite them in one mind, crown them in marriage, bless their union with the enjoyment of good children. For yours is the dominion, and yours is the kingdom, and the power and the glory of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and always, in the ages of ages. Amen. In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Eis tonum patros, et iuti pneumatos. In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Stephane adulto curioso, adulto tua Catarinis, eis tonum patros, et iuti pneumatos. The servant of God, George, is proud to the Lord Catherine, in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Stephen, the adult of Yorgo, the enduring of the Catherine's, is to all the patros, get it to prayer for us. Stephen, the enduring of the Catherine's, the adult of Yorgo, is to all the patros, get it to prayer for us.
Very self. And the wife must see to it that she respects
and the mother of Jesus was there. Jesus also was invited to the marriage with his disciples. When the wine gave out, the mother of Jesus said to them, "They have no wine." And Jesus said to her, "O woman, what have you to do with me? My hour has not yet come." His mother said to the servants, "Do whatever he tells you." Now 6 stone jars were standing there for the Jewish rites of purification, each holding 20 or 30 gallons. Jesus said to them, "Fill the jars with water." And they filled them up to the brim. He said to them, "Now draw some out and take it to the steward of the feast." So they took it. When the steward of the feast tasted the water now become wine and did not know where it came from, though the servants who had drawn the water knew, the steward of the feast called the bridegroom and said to him, "Every man serves the good wine first, and when men have drunk freely, then the poor wine. But you have kept the good wine until now." This the first of his signs Jesus did at Cana in Galilee, and manifested his glory, and his disciples believed in him.
Glory to you, O Lord, glory to you.
Η καταξίωση του μαζέστου με τα παρησία, ακατακρίτω το μαρτυρίστε σε, τον επολάνιο Θεό καθένα και λέγει. Πάτε λοιπόν, ο ενδύς ουρανής, αγιαστείτε το όνομά σου, ελθέτε την παρουσία σου, γεννηθείτε το θέλημά σου, ως τον ουρανό και την γης, τον άρχον ημών των επιούσιων, δώσε μην σήμερον, και άφησε μην τα οφειλήματα ημών, ως και εμείς αφήμεν τις πλέψεις ημών, και μη συνέχισης μας τους πειρασμών, αλλά λύσεις μας τους πειρασμούς all together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For yours is the kingdom and the power and the glory of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, now and forever to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Let us pray. God, who in your power created all things and established the world and made perfect everything you created, bless now with a spiritual blessing this common cup to be offered to those united in the fellowship of marriage. For blessed is your name and glorified is your kingdom, of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, now and forever. Amen.
Thank you. All the good gifts that God has to offer.
blessings and the blessings that are bestowed upon us here in this world. We ask God to bless us with all the good things, that our cupboards and our homes may be filled so we could share his blessings with the rest of the world. Christian action. We also said prayers for our parents, and we thank God that our parents are here with us. And we pray that the foundations of parents are built upon us right now by your action here today. We pray for the wedding company that is here, and we pray for all of you who are out there, who are witnesses today. For you're more than witnesses, you are participants. And you are all offering your prayers for George and Catherine. And we ask that once you leave here, that you weren't just invited, and you didn't come here just to attend a reception afterwards where we can celebrate. We will do that too. But that we go into our homes tonight, and we will offer prayer for George and Catherine. We will offer thanksgiving for ourselves to God for this joy and this blessedness. In the Orthodox sacrament that you have seen today, we have the blessing of the rings and the exchange of the rings. Rings are symbolic of, when you put them together, it forms a link, a chain. And we pray today that you have come together and you will form a chain, a bond. And this is something that we offer to one another to show something symbolic of an offering to one another, the ring. And then we have the blessing of the crowns. In ancient times, in ancient Greece, when athletes would run a race, when they reached the finish line, they would be rewarded with crowns of laurel leaves. And today, this is the finish line. You have run the good race. You have made it here. And now you are being rewarded with these crowns of glory. And those crowns, as the rings were exchanged from one to the other, because everything that you share in life will be exchanged. We stop being selfish. We stop thinking about ourselves, and we start thinking about one another. And then we shared the wine from the common cup. And this wine is sweet wine. And you shared it. And its symbolic symbolism is that you will share in all the sweetness that life has to offer. But also in this world that we live in, there is some bitterness. And we will share that too. But we have to learn how to overcome that bitterness. And we can only do that if we have God into our lives. And we allow Jesus to dwell within us. Because Jesus is dwelling between you now through the grace of the Holy Spirit. So as you leave today, you will walk out of this church, and all the preparations will be just a dream. The dress will go into the closet, the tuxedos will go back to where they came from, the flowers will go return to the earth, the limousines will drop us off, the photographers will just be a memory and offer us memories, the reception will be something in the past, but one thing will remain, and that is the blessing of God. This church will remain. The priest will remain. All of the things that are important will remain here. All these things we create to make it look nice, because this is a special day, and we want the best and share the good things of the Lord has to offer in this world. But let us never forget what's most important, and that is the blessing that we have received today, not from the priest, but from God above, with the love being witnessed and shared it by all the attendants and all of you, the witnesses experience this love that we are able to share between us. And those of you who are already married, this is an opportunity for us to also to listen to these prayers and to remember that the love that we have between us is from God, the Creator Himself. George, Catherine, God bless you. We wish you, as the prayer says, length of days and a marriage filled with love and all the good things that this world has to offer, which comes from our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. George, you may kiss the bride. This time I'd like to invite the parents, both parents to come and Vanessa to come and give their best wishes.
Are you married? here. Look, it's a, here comes
the bride. You can take some too.
I need you two to look down at your flowers. Hold it. Okay, I just want to take one of the bride alone. Just step aside, just like that. Okay, now pop your head through the door.
Good.
take a picture with my camera?
Okay, Helen, let's worry about the big winning.
Oh, George.
No, I know, but these are called copies. You're going to get
two. Can I catch you? Not here, George.
His name's David.
Who's the mad scotch drinker?
Just step to the side. Guys, girls, stay there. Guys, step to the side.
Okay.
You're not going to be able to. Good. Tighten up a little bit.
Tighten up early again.
Helen, lower your flowers a little bit. Flowers, Helen, Tina, a little higher. This side higher. Good. Just the guys.
Okay. I'm going to picture my face.
Oh, yeah. First
we call
the
phone.
Okay.
You should be.
Oh,
I love you. Cody, not psycho right now. Not beating up George.
Good. All right, hold on. Okay, put your arms around those two older girls.
Lean. Lean.
Lean.
Oh, wow. Oh, God, your hands are so cold.
Look at his arms.
You don't realize how tall he is.
He's almost 6'4".
We don't like this one. This is a little cheesy.
Oh, come on.
Justin,
oh,
it's all cheesy.
Come out. That's the problem.
Come on. Do it. One, two, three. Go ahead.
Cheese.
Good. 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 Okay, good.
Flash work this time. You notice that.
Okay. Are we done?
Yeah, you're all done. Let's get a shot of the good. Okay, I want the two of you, I want you looking down at her. You're going to look at your flowers, okay? All right, good.
Good, hold on. Good, good. One more. Good, hold on.
What
about the sunset?
We need that.
Oh, the sunset. Is that a omen?
We need that.
Is that an omen?
Or not.
Good luck, Kathy and George.
Good luck, Kathy. Have a good honeymoon.
One, two. Check one.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm proud to introduce to you
With a big round of applause, please. Catherine and George Papadimas. Let's hear one more time, ladies and gentlemen, for the beautiful bride and groom. A nice round of applause. And for the first dance they have selected from the Broadway musical Oklahoma, People Will Say We're In Love.
Thank you.
be seated.
Only Ortiz is going alone.
Before I offer the prayer, I just want to say, George and Catherine, maybe you didn't notice, but everyone in attendance noticed today that early in the day, there was an overcast. And as soon as you walked into the church, Catherine, all of a sudden the sun started streaming through the beautiful stained glass. And all of us here hope and pray that the Lord will continue to bless you and to guide you with his sun. And may those rays of sunlight always shine within your hearts and within your home. So let us all offer prayer. In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and always to the ages of ages. Amen. O Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, we thank you for gathering today. And we ask you to bless the food and drink of these your servants who have gathered for the blessed celebration as we celebrate the blessed sacrament of marriage between George and Catherine. We ask you to bring them peace, health, love, and all the good things that life has to offer. For you are a God who loves mankind, and to you we send up glory to the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and always to the ages of ages. Amen.
Thank you, Father. Ladies and gentlemen, please remain standing and pick up your champagne glass. I'd like to invite our best man, David Dwyer, to propose a toast to the newlyweds.
Go, David.
Go, David.
I can't see much, but I met George several years ago, obviously just after Kathy met George. The first memory I have of George is always going to be that George can get you tickets to anything. Anybody who's a friend of George is, for the first year, I think I never went to a movie, I've ever paid anything. It was always, Dave, I've got free tickets to the first showing of, what was that?
Waterworld,
that's the one. Plays, boat shows, whatever. I think I really got to know George the best, though, when we were ring shopping. George invited me to go ring shopping with him. I was honored. It's always something that I think men dread, but then afterwards I start to realize it was actually a little bit of fun. We had a really good time. That was uneventful, and we got started talking every day on the phone, and I started warning George, well, you know, there are going to be a lot of little things that go wrong with this wedding. You're going to get upset about him. So one day he called me up, and it was about a real small thing, and he said, Kathy wants to do this, and I don't want to do that. And I said, George, just say no. And he said, Dave, you don't understand. They're banging up on you. And I said, after having gone through all that myself, I understood exactly what he was saying. And they sort of take the divide and conquer approach. First, you know, Kathy says, I want this, George. Then her mom calls up and says, George, I really think we should do it this way. Then Helen calls up and says, yeah, no, this is really the way to do it. And followed up by Tina. All I can tell you, George, is it's been 2-4 right now. My father-in-law and me against the four of them. Now we're getting a little bit more even odds, 3-4. So that's working out pretty well. My father-in-law has always said that don't sweat the small stuff. That's not exactly how he says it, but he does the best job of anybody on that. He lets his wife win some of the small battles, but he definitely wins the larger battles. As I look at the two of them, I find that they've got a lot in common, but they've got a lot of differences as well. I found that most of the marriages in the Costales family, the women have a real propensity to talk a lot. My wife's like that, Tina's like that, Kathy's like that, and her mom's like that. George is very laid back, and I think that's a good match, and they can obviously enjoy each other, and I can tell that. They obviously have a lot in common, though, as well. I've seen George with his nephews. He's going to make a great father someday. Kathy, there's nobody else in the world that I would trust more than Kathy to take care of my son, Alex. She does a great job, and George, I told you at the rehearsal dinner, I'd love to be a brother-in-law. I'd even more like to be an uncle. I've never been an uncle, and that's, I hope you guys make me an uncle soon. Finally, George, when I got married to Helen, I guess it was 4.5 years ago, I knew I loved Helen, but the thing that I didn't realize is how much I'd love her family in the future. I think a mark of a good family is how good the marriages are in the family. And George, we make the third generation of marriages that I know of. Kimmon and Kay Haldas, I think, had an ideal marriage. Tay is here, and she's just a terrific grandmother to Helen. I would say Barbara and Nick Estalas are, I don't even like to call them in-laws. I think they're like second parents to me, and I think you'll find that as well. And it's just a terrific family, and I'm sure they'll be very welcoming to you as they've been to me. So I want to raise our glasses and say this was a beautiful wedding, or is a beautiful wedding. Have an enjoyable honeymoon, and here's to a wonderful new family.
Down a big round of applause and his own for the best man, David Dwyer, for a great speech. And let's hear one more time for the beautiful bride and groom, Catherine and George. A big round of applause. Thank you. Please be seated.
You want to say something to George?
Good luck. George, it's your birthday in 3 days. Happy birthday.
No, 2 days.
3 days.
Oh, 3 days. I'm sorry.
And today is my grandson's birthday.
Chris, 10th birthday today.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday, George.
Congratulations, Kathy, George.
Congratulations. Congratulations, George and Kathy. Happy birthday, George.
The bride, the groom, the parents, and the entire bridal party to start the Greek dancing with Orea Puninitimos. Thank you.
Congratulations.
Congratulations, Kathy.
Congratulations.
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 Yeah. Thank you.
that are not coming up? George, any passes out there that are not coming up?
No, we're all here. We're all set.
We're all here. Here we go, George. On the count of three. One, two, three. Okay, the young lady from Bourgain, please have a seat.
Yeah.